It's one people.
No. One. More like six.
That's too many people. Too much people even.
Are you scared? Are you now realizing that your words have an actual audience and what you say is
I'm disgusted.
Same thing basically. So what are you going to do about it?
I'm going to demand money from them.
Okay, so everyone, ladies and gentlemen, go to Xaverius.com and support his Patreon. If you are tier one supporter guy, then you get, I don't know, one can of Kofla.
No.
Oh.
It's not holding cans, and that will be a waste. Just give me money and I will yell at you.
I think I saw them in cans for a time.
Wait,
so well, those are small cans, they are not worth it.
So Kofla was sold in cans at one point?
It probably still is, but I disavowed their existence.
Well, that's too bad. It exists. So what are you gonna do about it?
Ignore it.
Well, that's actually a very very sensible reaction to the existence of canned Kofla. I mean, I wouldn't mind, but then again, I can't really get Kofla over here unless I import it and spend like 20 quid on two bottles of Kofla and some random Czech foodstuffs. And then I realize, oh my god, I just wasted 20 quid on a bunch of random Czech foodstuffs that I could have probably bought in Czech Republic for a fiver. Maybe in
each.
Mass. Yes.
They detect that you are from North Czech Republic and instantly they give you 600% tax.
They're like, this guy's from Western Europe, so that means he's loaded.
Exactly. He's like, he's from EU. I bet he gets grants every week. Let's rob him.
You guys are still in the EU as much as you don't like it.
Yes, but similar to Poland, we are there mostly because of the money.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's like...
No, at least Poland is not pretending.
So in other words, you guys are like, so they'll be convert to euros. That's like 2 euros. And then like, hey, wait, this guy's from Netherlands, he's probably loaded. Oh. That'll be 250. And I just shrugged my shoulders and be like, what ifs.
Okay.
So, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a new episode of Radio Rothingham, the least professional podcast on the internet. We are here with your co-hosts, your story, the Artrix. We got a Sekele with us.
Hello.
And a Bakphoon.
Bonjour.
And one Xaverius.
You said it wrong.
Xaverius?
I still can't tell you people apart.
Wait, I sound like Xaverius.
No, not you, but Xaverius and the other guy.
So all this time you just hear like one blob of a voice and it's all the fucking same to you.
It's interesting, I always found that I sound a lot like Messier.
No, I don't think so.
I do think so. When I was listening to stuff, I was like, okay, is it me or is it him? I can't... Oh, it was neither of us. It was Artrix.
So are you insinuating that I sound like you and Monsieur?
Yes, it was Ayoke.
Oh, okay. Anyway, I'm drawing the best sniper granny and only sniper granny in Vidya, Anna. And we're here to discuss various things that have happened on the internet in the past week or so.
Agree.
That is a very appropriate reaction to the following topic, which is YouTube being a shit.
My tube. I don't have any tubes.
Well, you do, anymore. Because you are
not
on the
after
internet.
The incident.
What incident?
The tube incident.
The tube incident. So what happened? We gotta need to hear all juicy details now.
Everything.
It's too hurtful to remember.
Remember.
Anyway, so once upon a forest, I mean time, there was a YouTube, and YouTube was like, "You warned me," and then the advertisers were like, fuck you too." And now there's a whole bunch of advertisers that are basically boycotting YouTube because YouTube won't sanitize its content. Because for years upon end, you know, Nissan and the Samsungs and whatnot were perfectly fine, just, you know, paying YouTube a bunch of money, and they were like, "YouTube, make sure that as many eyeballs get to see this as possible. Just, I don't care how you do it, just do it, okay? Just do it." And then you was like, okay. So YouTube just put their ads on all the relevant views, and it made the advertisers on YouTube a lot of money. But now all of a sudden the advertisers are like, "Oh my god, this video that you put my ad on is mean. These people are saying really mean things that we don't agree with. It's almost as if you explicitly agree and endorse this message. And now we don't want you to do that anymore."
Yes, indeed. I mean, as always, there are two sides to this. You have, in an ideal situation, similar to ideal situation in physics exercises, in an ideal situation, you have an advertiser who cares about nothing else but money and is absolutely disembodied from any way the ads appear on videos. Obviously, then you have those people who care about stuff that's happening on the internet. And obviously, if an ad appears on a video, it means that the advertiser directly placed it there in their own hands, like the CEO went. Mm-hmm. And open to video, like, "This is a nice video that I agree with. I'm going to put the ad here," and then took his ad stamp and stamped his monitor and sent it to the video creator so he knows where to place the ad. Except not. Yeah. Well, they don't have these people who are very concerned about stuff that's going on the internet, and they complain for some reason. I don't know why, but they do. And then apparently it's in the interest of the advertiser to take those ads down. Mostly it's probably just, you know, "Please leave me alone, I just want to sell shit." So they remove it. But then there's another complaint, and another, and then the advertiser sells no shit.
And that's how SJWs take over the world and kill everyone.
Yeah, and then there's the second angle that all the creators on the YouTube like to portray, is that the media is afraid of them.
Well, they are, because they're taking their jobs.
Exactly. These mostly unemployed people in their basements are taking their jobs. So they are pulling all their ads from the YouTube to kill them all and have their own content. Actually, there is a package from... I don't actually remember what kind of channel it was, but there's a package on YouTube for about $35 with programming. That sounds like a monumental stupid idea. Why would you watch programming on the internet? What kind of people? Like, no, you don't do that. Not even people who watch Netflix do that.
Yes.
I agree.
So yeah, now we've got a situation where a lot of people that have been providing content for YouTube and also making YouTube quite a buck. Like, for instance, according to the Amazing Atheist, he made YouTube like at least a few hundred grand, if not a million. And in the process of doing that, he also, you know, made himself a nice little living. But you know, with this shit going on, that might change. And if these content creators are not able to make ends meet, well, basically YouTube will devolve into what is essentially just 12 years old, just posting nothing but Minecraft videos.
So what's the difference when YouTube started out?
Well, when YouTube started out, it was basically just people fucking around doing nothing.
And posting setting stuff on fire.
I mean,
and posting songs with terrible font in the lyrics.
Did you see early YouTube content? That shit was fucking terrible. Like there was.
It was awesome. No. It's terrible for 2D standards.
Well, it's yeah, which goes to show just how easily pleased we were back then. But these days, you know, the kind of content we had, essentially the way YouTube was in the early early 2000s was
the early 20s.
Well, it wasn't even like.
YouTube like all those gangsters tweeting about prohibition and stuff.
Okay, that's hilarious. But yeah, if we look back at YouTube at the very beginning, it was essentially just people sitting in front of their webcam, just kind of talking. It was truly the Wild West of videos, and it was not really being taken serious by anyone but those on YouTube. It wasn't until like the early 20-teens when YouTube really became, well, serious.
Semi-serious.
Well, yeah. People, you know, were starting to get serious followings and whatnot. Which wasn't really the case in the late 2000s. I mean, the only real big guy on YouTube back then was like PewDiePie.
Well, angry video game nerd was before him.
That's true.
What did you just say, Artrix?
Did I say PewDiePie?
Yes.
Yeah, just the fact that you don't like him doesn't mean that he's big.
Just the fact that he's the only YouTuber you know doesn't mean he was alone back then.
He's far from the only YouTuber.
PewDiePie is relatively recent.
Yeah, too.
At least got fucking damn it mentioned Total Biscuit. He started in the same time, also got big pretty fast.
I suppose he came before PewDiePie. He's been around for a long time.
Yes, he started with World of Warcraft. Obviously, that's why you don't know about him.
Yeah, obviously, that's why I don't know about him.
Oh no, my stickers fell apart. Oh, YouTube. I suddenly have a topic now.
Oh. Okay, well, go ahead.
Okay, I think people that don't like stuff that other people say on the YouTubes should come and take some inspiration from our law system, because apparently there's been a guy, and he made a video about a person who's doing very good and legit stuff, like mapping your butt or doing vaginal therapy.
Mm-hmm.
She's a totally legit doctor and not a shaman at all, and he made a video about her. And I was like, here is a very stupid, retarded, idiotic person and other about 75 swear words, and now he went to court and he's going to jail for half a year.
So is he going to jail for slander or
it's not slander, it's actually more. How should I translate this? It's not slander.
Tell it in Czech. I might be able to translate it.
Basically, delinquents.
So, if I get this right, he's going to jail for what essentially amounts to bullying?
Well, he made a not nice video about a person, and then the person complained that she lost money because of him, and then he went to court, and got charged with disorderly conduct, and now he's going to spend a half a year in jail and another year under, what is it, probation?
That does sound like a form of slander, though, where one person sues another due to perceived loss of reputation and whatnot.
Yeah. But he was just like every other YouTuber, just, you know, yelling into a microphone about how retarded the other person is.
That it does set a very scary precedent.
Yeah, your country has to be nuked because of this now.
Yeah. Well, just nuked Prague. That should be enough.
I take you don't really like Prague.
No, it's full of Czech people. Ugh.
Mm.
They can't even speak proper Czech, Artrix.
Well, at least wait until I went there for a visit, okay? I still need... You know, Czech Republic is still kind of on my bucket list of places to go. And
give me a visit.
I mean, it's still on my list of European capitals to visit. So let me visit Prague before you destroy it, okay?
Yes, Czech Republic is on your list of capitals to visit, indeed.
Well, not you know, the entirety of Czech Republic, but just Prague.
Speaking of this censorship bullshit on YouTube, this kind of reminds me of how in the 1950s, the Comic Code Authority, which was a censorship system for comic books, essentially destroyed the American comic book industry, from which, by the way, it hasn't recovered till this day. Like, the reason why all American comics are just superheroes is because every single other genre was wiped out of existence during that era, and superheroes were the only thing that was able to survive.
Ah, well, that explains a few things. And still around, by the way. Like, if you pick up a random American comic, it will still say, like, approved by the American Comic Authority thingy. And that's how you know it's going to be.
In this day and age, it is a lot less strict than it used to.
Probably because they realize, oh, wait, sales are going down. No one's fucking reading comics anymore.
Well, mostly because that's kind of interesting. It happened thanks to Richard Nixon. Because, for example, originally you weren't able to depict drugs in comics in any form whatsoever.
Mm.
But then Richard Nixon or Ronald Reagan? Not sure which one, but it was a Republican.
Mm.
So they started this whole war on drugs. And they at first solicited Marvel, later DC, but first Marvel, to do some anti-drug PSAs. And of course, the Comic Code Authority said, no way, fuck you. And then the president said, fuck you back.
It's confusing.
And then the Comic Code Authority was essentially forced to relax their standards.
That makes sense.
And then later, and they started relaxing them more even later. As the society standards change.
So...
But yeah, basically, Code Authority, especially its hardcore version, which was in place during the 1950s and 1960s, caused the entire comic book industry in the USA to stagnate. And as I said, the industry hasn't recovered from said stagnation till this day.
Well,
because the only genre present is superheroes.
Well, that is the thing I don't really like about American comics. It seems to be that it's all just cape comics, and it doesn't really hold my attention.
The sad thing is that after the Comic Code Authority became less strict during the 70s, did in fact attempt to reintroduce the previous genres, you know, the genres that previously existed and that exist in the comic around the world, like Western, detective, horror, sci-fi, and other stuff. But the new generation that grew up with only superhero comics was unwilling to give them a chance, and so they didn't even catch on.
It's because they are not superheroes. It's their own fault.
So the industry was completely destroyed by this. And it looks like this same thing is going to happen to the internet. Or at least YouTube. But most likely the internet, or at least American internet in general.
Well, that sounds like a terrifying prospect.
Yeah, nuke everything. It's the only way.
I don't know about that. If you nuke everything, I wouldn't be able to finish this drawing off. So
then nuke it once you are finished.
Okay. Well, that sounds like when you're here first, folks.
I thought we were nuking everything just so Artrix can't finish it.
That's sad.
Exactly.
I take you don't like Sniper Granny.
No, I don't like you.
Oh.
She's okay, but...
What a silly question.
Takes skill.
So yeah, we'll have to wait and see, because this isn't exactly the first time YouTube went on this purge, so to speak. It's not the first time they started trying to make the site more quote-unquote advertiser friendly. So chances are that this will just blow over and they're just gonna be sort of...
Yeah, it didn't work because the advertisers are not very friendly now.
Yeah, but this happened in the past. It's not the first time advertisers were starting to be all like, oh, this content is too edgy. Out the edge. We need more family-friendly content. And that happened for like 2 years or so. And then everything basically went back to the status quo.
But I'm afraid they may cause irreparable damage by the time they stop. Because back then, the SJWs weren't as aggressive as they are now. And now they'll jump at any opportunity to wipe out their opposition.
I don't know. I mean, public awareness of SJWs and what they do has increased significantly. And once a big interest is like, oh, wait, this isn't... reading in lots of money now because the normies are no longer using YouTube, then they may change their tune.
But it will be too late. just like it was too late for the comic piece when the comic code relaxed.
Well, we'll see. I mean, these things, right now, YouTube is making all sorts of weird little jumps, like a cat being forced in a corner. So it will do a bunch of really batshit crazy things, but once this whole thing dies down a bit, well, we'll see what they'll do exactly. And who knows, maybe we all just need to move over to Minds.com and just have our you know, YouTube hookers and booze and beer and whatnot.
So yeah, by the way, considering we are recording, I repeat the same shit that I said before the stream started. For some reason, and I have no idea if these things are connected, they started playing, at least for me, they began playing recruitment videos for the Slovak armed forces on YouTube with no option to skip them. And these are generally 1 to 2 minutes long videos.
They're trying to tell you something.
Yeah, get in the military. Die for your country. Do it now.
The thing is, I did in fact at one point try to join the military. They didn't want me.
Why?
Because I have asthma.
So you can't join the military because you've got asthma? Huh. I didn't know that they were asthma phobic. Well, here's what you do.
Basically, you have to be perfectly fit to join the military, at least over here.
Yeah. So what you do is you start a Tumblr, and you tell the world just how asthmaphobic they are, and before you know it, they're having to deal with hundreds of angry Tumblrites who are outraged that they can't join the military because they're asthmatic.
Tumblr doesn't work on Slovakia. That's the first thing. And second thing, I'm not as interested as I used to be, because at that one point I was pretty desperate for a job.
Oh, so it wasn't even like, oh, I gotta serve my country. It was more like, well, I need the cash. And
yeah,
they were like, no, fuck off.
Nope. And then he became a mercenary.
Yeah, just become a like mercy. Oh, wait.
Snake!
No snake. Oh, it's a snack.
Badger.
Mushroom.
And a snack. Don't forget the snack.
Not enough badger.
Also, there's another thing that triggered a lot of people and also triggered a specific article. And that was a great, great segue. So yeah, so Theresa May, you may have heard her in this patriarchal society where men are pulling
you, Theresa,
all...
may have heard about her.
Yes. We live in such a patriarchal society in which women are completely subjected to the will of men. Theresa May was absolutely no woman whatsoever. Triggered Article 50 of the Lisbon Treaty, and now the England is Brexiting, and it's happening, Dutchie back. So, yeah. From what I gather, it doesn't mean that the UK is now out of the EU. It's still in there, but at least they can now start with the negotiations to see what their relationship with the EU is going to be from here on out. So obviously the UK is going to restore the British Empire, and it's going to be glorious. I don't know.
God save the Queen.
This is actually, well, I actually don't like the current national anthem. I like the other one more. Something Britannica. It's way more uplifting. The current anthem is kind of gloomy. So you listen to it, it's like, oh yeah, this is kind of a dreary song.
Well, they lost India.
Yeah, but you can still have the same anthem, can you? What's stopping them from using that anthem? I mean, Russia still has the same theme song as the USSR. It's not the USSR anymore, but they're still using...
They brought back the old anthem. If I remember correctly, correct me if I'm wrong, they did in fact change their anthem after the Soviet Union collapsed, but then when Vladimir Putin became the country's new president / prime minister, he restored the Soviet anthem.
Oh, so in other words,
all I know is they kept the music, and then some country kind of fucked it up and they played the old one and everybody was very horrified. It was fun.
Well, doesn't well, yeah, the new and the current anthem at the same melody. That's the same melody as the USSR anthem, but the lyrics are different for obvious reasons.
This is, by the way, kind of interesting because Putin brought back both symbols of the Soviet Union as well as symbols of Imperial Russia, like back from the monarchy. Basically combined the coolest things from Russia's history.
But why would he
make
do such
present
a thing?
Russia? Rule of cool?
Just rule of cool. Just because,
probably.
Because there were cool, they're cool symbols and everyone likes a cool symbol. Well, that makes sense. So yeah, the England should obviously do that too. They should return to the old anthem, and I don't know. What else do they do? Well, maybe rebuild their old empire. I don't know, but make it, you know, rebuild their old empire, but make it more in line with the current generation. So in other words, instead of trade,
generation sucks.
Yeah, but you know, if you want the support, you know, you gotta make some concessions. So it's gonna be like, okay, guys, listen up. We're going to restore the English Empire, and then everyone's like, oh my God, please don't. And then it's like, oh wait. It's we have taken your concerns into consideration, and we also decided to make everything more culturally diverse, and that means that from now on in the English Empire there's gonna be, I don't know, Skrillex everywhere and dank memes.
I hope it's not 8 Skrillex though.
And let's not forget that watching and Let's Play will be mandatory. And I don't know. I don't know what your kids are into these days, but we'll do it. We'll do it for you. Just so you accept the new British Empire, okay? And then I was like, okay, whatevs. Also, at this point, it doesn't really matter anymore because globalism. It's like, oh, I guess we're on the British rule now, but everything is exactly the same. Everything. So yeah, does anyone have any thoughts on Brexit actually happening?
Donald Tusk, who is basically the president of the EU, commented about the Brexit and if there will be any punishments for the UK for leaving EU, and he said that the Brexit is already the message that Brexit is already punishment enough for them.
Well, are you really surprised? I mean,
he's Polish, you know, so he's under the mentality that EU equals free money. So now that they are coming out of it, they won't get free money anymore.
Also,
that he forgets that the UK was the one giving most of the free money.
Also,
Germany is. UK was like, the Britain actually kind of got a deal, and I think they were like the fourth or fifth country that gave the most money. Like, of course, Germany was the first one, then I think France.
Yeah, but Germany is also the biggest economy in the EU, so that makes sense. But yeah, I'm not entirely surprised that one guy that has a very big interest in making the EU succeed is going to be a petty fuck towards the British for leaving the EU. I don't know, it kind of sounds like something someone would say who has a very big interest in keeping the EU up and running. I don't know.
Wow.
Such insight. I deserve a Nobel Prize right now. I'm going to Sweden, right? Oh no, I'm no. I kept myself from making a big mistake. I was going to Sweden, but then I realized Sweden is currently a war zone, so I won't.
Sweden sucks.
I don't know why, but lately I don't really feel very big. I don't really have a big incentive to go to Sweden. I don't know why. Well,
probably because ISIS basically conquered it.
Might have something to do with it. Just maybe. But yeah, the EU leaders are salty as fuck because they see one of their biggest economies basically telling them to GTFO, and we're just going to do our own thing now. And
the sad part is they probably won't learn their lesson from this.
Well, we'll still have to see what France is gonna do, if they're gonna vote in some really Eurosceptic.
Well, yeah, but if France leaves, then what's the point of us staying?
Well, you got a point there. If France decides to Frexit, then it's probably curtains for the EU. Because at that point, it's basically like, yeah, so what do we have left? Well, there's Germany and...
That's about it.
Yes, and... You got Netherlands. We can hold the entire EU economy by our own. I mean, we're pretty awesome, but not that awesome. So yeah, if France decides to you know, vote in politician that's incredibly anti-EU, that might be curtains for the EU. And then we're going to see how we're going to run this continent without this monster of a of intergovernmental organization.
There is still Putin.
Yeah, let's just join the USSR. Let's just bring the shit back. I mean, at that point, you might as well just, you know, be like, oh, you know what? Fuck it. Let's try again. Putin, just recreate the USSR. We're just gonna try it again, okay? But then it's like, fuck off. So something tells me that he secretly wishes the USSR would, you know, come back.
Putin definitely. And I know that some people over here do.
So you think Putin secretly wants the USSR to come back?
More or less. Or at least, you know, make Russia great again.
Well, it doesn't matter if it's USSR, as long as it's under his rule.
Mm-hmm. Well, it kind of already has, so... I mean, let's be honest here. He is, you know, more or less running the country with an iron fist. I don't really get the impression that there is a lot of political opposition, so to speak. I don't know, it just, you know, you just don't really get that impression from Russia right now. It's like Putin this, Putin that. What about anyone else?
You don't see the real opposition. The dark Putin. He's keeping us all safe.
Mega Putin versus Putin. This weekend on pay TV, whatever. But yeah, yes. So obviously what we as Europeans should do is just, you know, disband the entire EU and just create a better EU with blackjack and hookers.
Oh my god.
And one that's actually accountable to the people and whatnot. But, you know, that's just a pipe dream of mine. It's almost as much of a dream as the pipe strip. And those who get the reference, you win one free internet.
I was listening.
You are blind. The cat has your pipe.
He does, but you see, I'm one step ahead, and I actually planted explosive in the pipe, and look at that! There's no cat anymore. The pep does not have my pipe, neither do I, but it was all worth it.
Well, the pipe was already full of cat drool anyway.
Mm-hmm. But now the drool's all over the room, and now I've created a cat torture room because this cat drool all over it. And
you have very weird and specific fetishes, Artrix.
And the entire room is the same color, so the cat has no means of orientating.
Nope. No, because it can sense the cat that used to be in there. And since the colors also are maddening to it, yes.
This maddens the cat.
It's a shot, so.
Madden.
But yeah, if you.
John Madden.
BBBB, or whatever it was. Something retarded like that. But yeah, if you haven't seen it yet, look up the pipe strip thing. It's. Well, you do have it's to clear. Art. Yeah, it is. It's basically art. It's.
How disturbing. I would just suggest such a thing.
Anyway, I think we're talking about the EU and how it's like the pipe strip, I guess.
At least it's not a hyperloop.
But does it make the Fibonacci sequence?
The EU? Not really. The flag is just a bunch of stars in a circle. So maybe if
it's not even solar powered.
That too.
Come on, guys. You can do better.
So it is an incomplete Fibonacci sequence.
I guess.
Solar freaking EU.
So what you're saying is that if we make the EU solar freaking roadways, it will work?
Obviously. Everything works when it's powered by solar power.
Hmm. Especially EUs.
Especially roads, yes. I mean, just the concept of roads that are powered by... Wait, you need to power roads?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, the ESMC squared, checkmate atheists, they obviously need power to exist. You can't have roads without power.
Yeah, so it's a special kind of road that consumes power to exist.
Yeah, so, you know, our current inferior roads that we have right now, they, you know, they don't use any power, and that's obviously...
Artrix, if roads need power to exist, and we never heard about roads consuming power yet, and they are definitely not solar powered because there are no solar panels.
Mm-hmm.
What are the roads that exist now getting their power from?
Well, you see, the roads that we have now are obviously inferior because they're not solar powered.
Are they stealing our children and hobos to power themselves?
No, they're not powered. So that obviously means they should not exist. Therefore, we need to replace all the roads with solar freaking roadways.
Oh, so you're saying that the entire time we've been using roads, we've been actually using your roads that didn't even exist?
Yeah, we've been using phantom roads, basically. It was just a big, you know, illusion.
A big empty shell of a road. It was not a real activated road.
Mm-hmm. All this time we've just been, you know, riding on dirt. But we were too... Yeah, we were just not concrete, just dirt. Like there's no road or anything, just dirt. Because we basically just fool ourselves into believing, oh, there's a road here, but in reality there's nothing. There was just, you know, there was just nothing. And then God created light, I guess. But, you know, then you have to use the light to create solar freaking roadways, obviously. I mean, what else are you going to use all that light for? Just let go to waste? Is that what you want for the children of the future? I won't rest until we've got a world in which every single road is replaced by a solar freaking roadway.
Sounds good.
Yeah, let's do it right now. I'm doing jack shit to do it because I'm drawing Anna, but I bet that Anna who lives in the future, by the way, so she's probably born around this time. So yeah, just imagine, you know, being Anna and you live in a world without solar freaking roadways. That sounds terrifying to me. I don't wish that kind of fate to the Annas of the future. I mean, how else are you going to see your enemies while you're about sniping people? You need sort of freaking roadways to you know, put some nice light on those fuckers.
You missed a very nice pun there.
What was the pun?
Anamis.
Oh, that was corny. Okay, I think there was one more topic to discuss. I'm not even sure how long we've been recording.
Well, yeah, it was specifically the two bastions of social justice. On one side, Anita Sarkeesian's feminist frequency, and on the other side, Polygon.
So in other words,
are locked
okay.
In civil war over furries.
That's so terrifying. So
oh, that's a new low.
It is a new low. It's like watching a train wreck. I mean, it's basically watching two retards fight at this point. So it's like, it's like we're Polygon's like, we're super progressive, but that furry looks kind of hot. But then Nita's like, that's sexist. And then Polygon's like, no, it's not sexist, because here's a 6-page essay about the ramifications of approving of this sort of content and how it is socially acceptable.
And basically, what it all boils down to is that Sarkeesian believes that furries are degenerate and must be banned. Because they only sexualize women. And Polygon.
Well, she doesn't have the right reasons, but I do agree with Anita.
And Polygon says that it's kink shaming, and therefore Anita is a bigot.
There's no winners in this story, except for me.
Oh. Because Camp Anita all the way, as for me.
Because you don't like furries.
Who likes furries? Come on.
Well, Penboy likes furries, and he's
you
not
know
a
who
rat.
Likes you know who likes furries, Artrix?
Hitler.
Furries like food.
Oh, okay. I was gonna you know go full Godwin's law and say that Hitler liked furries.
No, Hitler liked Disney cartoons. He's even worse.
Well, that is the precursor to furries, sort of, and he also had and he also liked dogs. So obviously, he was a furry.
Yeah.
I mean, my mother likes dogs, but yeah, so that obviously means he's a furry too.
She's a furry, which means you are a furry, or your entire family needs to be purged.
Mm-hmm. Well, except for me, of course. That's fine.
You are a furry by extension.
Mm-hmm.
And also, the best part is that now many feminists who previously would worship Anita as some sort of messiah are now starting to tear her down because of her sex negative attitude.
Oh, that's definitely not the first time for that sort of thing to happen. I remember that time when literally who decided, you know what, I'm going to talk to this guy. I'm just gonna go to a bar. I'm going to sit down. I'm just going to talk to him. Just gonna sit there and talk and see if we can find some common ground. And then everyone lost their shit. And I clearly remember one tweet being along the lines of, oh, now I no longer have to pretend to like Wu's game. Because he's obviously a bigot, Nazi, misogynist, racist now.
What is this? Talking?
I don't remember. It's also not really worth remembering anyways.
No, what's this talking? I don't understand. I'm trying to convey your opinions in such a manner that they are not completely impenetrable and leave space for the other person to say something. This is all wrong.
Mm-hmm. They were obviously committing wrong think right there. I mean, double plus bad.
How dare they?
I don't know who the other guy is. He had like the Simpsons avatar, Walt Wilson kind of. But you know, he was obviously one of the goober gators, and every SJW hated him because
yes, he was.
But yeah, basically what I'm seeing here is the retards basically fighting amongst themselves and, you know, seeing who can out social justice the other.
Out retard.
Hmm?
It's the retard competition and everybody loses.
Mm-hmm. It's like that time when you know, one of the social justice people were more or less found out to be a pedo, and then everyone went in and was like, you know what, maybe we shouldn't be so hard on these pedophiles. Maybe they're just misunderstood.
Same people with AIDS.
Mm-hmm. You know, maybe we should be more harsh towards people with AIDS. They're terrible people. Oh, it's one of us now. Oh, AIDS is a terrible disease. And you know, once the whole thing with PewDiePie came about, well, everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked. I mean, when you know, they discovered, Milo Yiannopoulos is pedo, so now we're going to move all the articles advocating for pedophilia and how we shouldn't treat it as something bad anymore.
But they didn't expect people to archive them.
Mm-hmm. Well,
now you can rub it all right into their faces.
See that? See this here? That's what you wrote. You wrote about a year ago. You weren't really as critical about pedos as you know. As Milo, and to be perfectly fair, Milo was more or less advocating that it was perfectly fine to have sexual relations with 13-year-old boys. That's not exactly something I'm going to, you know, approve of.
What did you expect? He's gay.
he was being a shit there.
Yay!
Hooray!
What are we celebrating?
Yes.
We are celebrating yes. Because obviously well, those boys nice consent.
Well, Yes is a nice band.
Who?
Yes.
Who is a nice band?
It's a nice group.
Oh yeah, yes, I know.
Who's a great band?
Yes.
I agree. There's also a band called The.
Oh, that's D.
They're active in the 80s.
Hmm. Yeah, there's a lot of bands with city names like that. There's one in Netherlands named Band Without a Name, or
Boom.
Yeah.
Well, there's a band or a group from Slovakia that's literally called No Name.
Mm. I guess that's a common theme with bands.
They are very creative.
So, what sort of music do they make? Is it like really corny music? Or is it actually something palatable?
It is above average pop. All
right.
Right.
But there's something.
Back
there's something that I noticed kind of recently. It's not really a topic, more of an addendum to the SLW topic. Like especially this year, like the games that released, if you look at the Western released games, like especially a big anticipated title, Mass Effect, which is pretty much, you know,
a piece of shit.
Exactly. But it's also known.
Yes, I'm letting myself talk. It's such a good game that on the weekend, in the week of its release, which means less than 5 days, it got on sale for about a quarter of its price. Wow, such a good game.
That is very desperate. Anyway, back was...
they announced a teaser that basically they will talk on April 4th about how they want to progress further with Mass Effect, like, you know, patching and everything.
On April 1st?
No, on April 4th.
Oh, okay, because if they were legit gonna announce it on April 1st, that would be hilarious.
Yeah, but also, like, you see, like, it's a Western game. It got plenty of SLWs on the team working. You had kind of poor character choices, but, you had pretty much just diversity, but not, normal people, just diverse, special people.
I think one of the people working on the game, and I think it's one of the leading designers, straight up said that he hates white people and won't allow them to be in the game, at least playable.
Yeah, exactly. And then you look like at all those kind of Japanese produced games, like you have Nier, you have Zelda Breath of the Wild, you have now Persona 5, which all pretty much are getting the best ratings that you can get, because the developers just don't give a flying fuck about the SJWs.
Flying fug.
Exactly, flying fug. And it's like suddenly it's amazing games.
Mm-hmm.
Like, because the previous years, the Japanese developers struggled very much, and now suddenly, like, especially this year, notice it. Like, suddenly they're like back to form. Like, they produce amazing games, and the Westerners, as I said, it is just like Westerners have like all this politically correct but mostly buggy games, and Eastern games or Japanese games are like good.
They just make what they like and they don't give a shit about anything else.
Exactly.
The thing about Mass Effect, from what I gather, is that it's a lot of checkbox diversity for diversity's sake. It's like, well, we need this ethnicity in there, check. We need that one in there, check.
Well, it's Bioware.
And also, fuck all cis white hat male sour.
As they shown in Dragon Age Inquisition. Being gay is the sole defining trait of a character sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And here it's, well, you have the feminist, You have the other feminist, you have the black person, you have the other 30,000 black persons, and if you, God forbid, want to create your own characters, you have a plenty of choice of skin colors from illegal immigrant to born in Congo.
Oh God.
Also, that they are also fucking ugly.
Well, yeah, that's true. Some of my friends will argue that, well, you see...
I don't.
You see, demand creates demand. So now that these games are out there, there will be more demand for these sorts of games. And
so, you're saying that if I make a piece of shit and put it on the market, people start wanting pieces of shit.
That's what they argue.
It works with Call of Duty, so yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Only that nobody wants Call of Duty anymore.
Yeah, people kind of got sick and tired of Call of Duty.
Finally, I mean, Call of Duty was ruining the industry throughout the entirety of the 2000s and early 2010s.
Mm-hmm. Not so much anymore.
I hate that era of gaming.
Well, aren't they one of the first to try and do the whole yearly release thing where they basically release a new game every year?
Stupid, because games need time to develop. Making a new game every year just means that they won't be any good.
Well, to be fair, Call of Duty has, I think from what I know, has two studios. So basically there are two studios that go in order. So basically they have a two-year development cycle for Call of Duty.
They're still not very long for Vidya.
But then you have a five-year development cycle and you get Mass Effect and Andromeda. But I think with this move, BioWare might join the ranks of Westwood and Maxis.
Except when those ended, they were good.
I don't know about Maxis, because Maxis wasn't Maxis absorbed into EA after SimCity flopped.
They made Sims. Yes, indeed.
And I was talking about SimCity 2013. That was a very successful video game that everyone remembers very fondly. And City Skylines is a game no one fucking knows.
City Skylines sucks. It doesn't even have Sim in the name.
Did you even play it?
No, it doesn't have Sim in the game. Obviously, it's an action shooter, not a simulation.
Okay. Well, this is true. There is a lot of shooting in that game.
Yeah, I bet.
Shooting streets. Solar freaking road. Oh my god. There needs to be a mod for City Skylines.
Yes.
I'm sure it is.
Somebody should mod in Hyperloop and Solar freaking road. And... I don't know, self-filling water tanks.
Oh yeah, make it so that instead of building water pumps, you just build nothing but water seers.
Self-filling solar loop.
so you basically have like just this like 2/3 of the entire map is just nothing but water seers to provide this little town of, you know, few drops of water. Look, you guys, it really works. Look at all the goddamn water these water seams are producing. An entire city is getting its water from the water seers. A city with a population of 5, but...
But look at all those water seers, they work.
Mm-hmm.
That is legally not a city. That's not even a village.
We'll make it legal, as they would say.
Well, there's a town in Australia that has one person living in there. It's still a town. But then again, that's Australia.
I do know that Slovak Republic has legal requirements. Like in the number of people that have to live in a place for it to qualify as a town or for it to even qualify as a village.
Yeah, I think most jurisdictions have that. but that's kind of out of the scope of the joke. The joke is that water seers are very good at reclaiming water from thin air. Like it's very energy efficient, and it will never go wrong, and it's the best invention ever. You should probably go ahead and donate all your money to the Water Seer project. I mean, they made a really nice looking animation showing you how it works, so obviously they know their shit. I mean, never mind that there's no working prototype or anything that you can see right now.
You don't need a working prototype, you just need to believe.
Yeah, exactly. Just, no.
Listen and believe!
Exactly.
In this case, watch and believe.
In this, yeah. You know, forget trust and verify. That's just Goober Gator saying that.
Yeah, here. Look, this thing has a video and computer animations of suffering people who are women and black. So you have no excuse to not give us money.
Mm-hmm. You don't want to be responsible for the thirst of women and children in third world countries, do you?
Yeah. And are you a racist?
Yeah, if you do, you're probably a racist and a misogynist. All at the same time.
Yeah. And it's all in animated graphics, so the believing is so much easier.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, the only thing they achieve by this is making being racist and sexist look more attractive.
Well, more attractive than those poor Africans who are so malnourished that you can see their ribs.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you are into that.
I'm pretty sure there's people into that. I mean, there's people into, you know...
Well, there are people who think Paris Hilton is hot, so...
Exactly. There's also people that think blowing up girls with hot air is really hot. They also draw like this blue bear character. I don't know what's that all about.
All of them, all those people.
Mm-hmm.
All this great non-specific group of people that you are mentioning.
Yes. Though I'm pretty sure there's more than just, you know, Andrew Dobson is not the only one doing that. There's definitely a large group of people who are into inflation fetish art. I don't understand
why anyone would be.
I don't get the appeal either. It's a really big thing, and a lot of people are into it, and I just don't
I
see
do
it.
Know, I do know that this sort of shit used to be a very common joke back during the golden age of animation. But even there, it wasn't meant sexually. It was just, you know, slapstick.
Yeah, people being blown up like a balloon is nothing new. That shit's been going on forever. But, you know, like you said, the fetishization...
It was never intended to be sexual.
Exactly. But a lot of people seem to find it very sexy. And I don't know why.
Why?
Well, I guess there's a power element to it. Like, people like, yeah... You're blown up with air, so now you're defenseless, I guess.
They can float now. They'll just float away.
Yeah, that makes it even harder to do whatever it is you were about to do. So, good job. You do not win a prize, and you cannot go past going, don't collect $200. Okay, I'm gonna check, and yeah, we're at the 1 hour mark, so I guess we can bring up one more topic before we call it a night. So, there was a topic you want to bring up, Sekele.
Yeah, there was the whole thing. Well, first off, Cartoon Network brought up their lineup for 2017 and 2008 and early 2018. There is an interesting bit that the International Cartoon Network brought up their lineup, and then Cartoon Network Russia brought up a lineup, and the two lineups were kind of different, which wouldn't be, you know, so shocking if not for the fact that the Russian lineup had obviously Western-looking, obviously Western-made shows, that were not present in the international lineup, but that's beside the point. One thing I would like to point out, considering we were just talking about diversity and so on, one of the shows that were confirmed on the lineup for International Cartoon Network was a new show called Craig of the Creek.
Mm-hmm.
From what I it's made by some people who worked on Adventure Time, and seeing how Adventure Time is ending, you know, the show's premise, at least from what I saw, seems to be that there is this post-apocalyptic world.
That seems because really Adventure common. Time did. Yeah, that's a recurring theme in
a post-apocalyptic world. Only here, the only humans still alive are children.
Ugh, that's disgusting.
That is a very terrifying picture of the future.
The show's main character is black. And what is interesting, obviously progressive step, Tumblr is completely silent about it. You know, as if it never even happened. On the other hand, however, 4chan is going insane. Like, 4chan is having a freaking meltdown over it and calling it proof that SJWs has to have completely taken over the Western animation industry and that all hope is lost.
Okay, those are two extreme stars.
This is the sort of meltdown that Tumblr would have. I would not expect it from 4chan.
In other words, both
you,
factions.
But you
are...
would not expect 4chan getting butthurt about the end of the Western anything.
Hmm.
Have you been going to the same 4chan I was?
Well, maybe they're secretly not the same 4chan. Maybe whenever you visit, they just they all swap places and.
I'm pretty sure they all like traps, so it's all the same fortune.
Okay.
I was mostly talking about CO.
Yes.
CO is like fortune light these days.
Yeah.
But they got butthurt over it. Like, you know, if it was Paul, then okay, I might not be surprised. But this is freaking CO we are talking about.
Well, okay.
As extremist parts of 4chan.
Well, yeah, but to be fair, I think there is a fair number of Poltards on Ko as well. Considering
Poltards are everywhere.
That too. They're even on YouTube, and now they're going to take all their ad revenue away. Illuminati confirmed.
Oh no.
And I do find it interesting that after the whole storm Tumblr pulled over OKKO, Let's Be Heroes, which by the way is present on the International Cartoon Network's lineup, so it's going to premiere during 2017. It's kind of interesting considering what a fit Tumblr threw over that show having a black creator and not having a black main character. And now they have a show with a black main character and they are ignoring it, acting like it doesn't exist.
Well, here's the thing. So you listing all these things about all these shows and the ethnicity of all the characters and how this show has not enough black people in it and the other show has too many minorities in it and blah, blah, blah. All I can think is, why do people care so much? Why is this in our collective consciousness these days? I mean, for fuck's sake, here I am drawing a woman in a fucking veil and I don't fucking care because Anna is a cool character to play and I don't care that she's...
That just means, Artrix, that internally you are sexually identifying as a 60-year-old woman.
Yeah, obviously, if Tumblr is anything to go by, I'm probably trans and transsexual. think trans ethnic and also trans religious.
Trans ageist.
And trans ageists. Let's not forget that.
Personally, I'm just a trans nigger.
Mm-hmm. So, do you listen to a lot of rap? Do you like chicken wings? So, do you like watermelon?
That's all very racist stereotypes.
Do you like Barack Obama?
Homie, stop with these stereotypes. that reminds me, you remember Rachel Dolezal?
The what now?
The person who decided that she's also a trans nigger.
What about her?
Yeah. And then everybody hated her for being a trans nigger. Well, she wrote a book. She wrote a book, and I noticed two things. She still uses her Czech name, with Je, Dolezal. And second, she's very serious about being a trans nigger. And now you have the SJWs who are all 40 trans people, and they can't really make an argument against her that wouldn't, you know, disvalidate their arguments about transgender people.
So in other words, what's saying is that a lot of SJWs don't like her?
Exactly.
Why?
Because they can trouble their arguments at her now. It's not her fault that she's been wrong. She's been born with the wrong skin color, right? It's like with the people whose fault it is not that they were born with the wrong gender, huh?
Right. Checkmate atheists.
Yeah, Czech, literally, because you know Czech surname. Mm-hmm. She's probably like 1/8 Czech. And as medieval POC Tumblr says, in medieval Europe there were only black people. So yeah, it's obvious where she has the black part of her from.
Oh yeah, if Google's anything to go by, you know, all Europeans are black. There's probably a bit of a black person in me too.
Yeah, or
this enrages
black.
Me so much.
Sorry?
I just feel so much hate.
Wait. Do you feel a lot of hate because Google decides to be a retard?
No, because someone claims that Europe was all black people. I'm very much into history, and so historical inaccuracies tend to piss me off.
That makes sense. So, as a historian, and I'm not talking as an internet historian, though I have to be fair, yeah, the sure. Internet historian is pretty funny. Like, he was covering the whole hunt for the he does not divide his flag, which apparently is still ongoing. We're up to season 5 now.
Oh, wait. Shia LaBeouf moved the flag from Britain.
Yes. That only lasted for a day. And within a day, someone managed to climb up there, but they realized that they didn't bring scissors. So they got kind of fucked. But
the best thing about 4chan.
But at least they got up there. I mean, this time it wasn't really a matter of finding the flag, but more of a matter of how are we going to get up there and, well, mess with it. And all sorts of contraptions were thought up and no one succeeded.
They did intend to bomb it with drones at one point.
Yes. But, you know, they took down the flag. So in a way they did win because... Well, they took down the flag. That was kind of funny. And I lost my train of thought. Good job.
Well, we were talking...
Like Oh, yeah. As an internet historian, what's your expert opinion on the notion that we was black? I mean, kings.
It's true and false at the same time. Because, yeah, there were kings. But not of the country they keep thinking. Yes, they were at some point black Egyptian pharaohs, but they were not the majority. There was an era during the history of Egypt where their southern neighbors, back then it was called the Kingdom of Kush, did in fact occupy their northern neighbors, Egypt, and there were pharaohs, like black pharaohs. Only that, you know, it was not the natural state of being. They eventually got overthrown and replaced by the native, not black Egyptian pharaohs. and that way it stayed until the Persians invaded, and you know, and there were in fact black kingdoms, even advanced black kingdoms in Africa, as the already mentioned Kingdom of Kush and Kingdom of Aksum, also located in present-day Sudan and northern Ethiopia, and of course Ethiopia itself, which was independent. Well, throughout its entire history, it was an independent black African Christian kingdom that only lost its independence very briefly during World War II, when it was occupied by fascist Italy. There were also the African kingdom of Ghana, Mali, and Songhai in West Africa, which, by the way, were big slave traders and sold many black slaves to Europeans. And of course, there was Great Zimbabwe in South Africa. But none of these people who keep screaming, "We was kings," seem to even know that these existed in the first place. So technically, they are right, but they are also completely retarded.
They are technically right about one piece of part of history.
That they basically want to give you the impression that, yeah, instead of, you know, the French aristocrats with their big wigs and the fancy dresses and whatnot, it was black people walking around being fancy. And
these assholes, in fact, even keep claiming that ancient Greece and ancient Rome were all black people. I'm not kidding.
Obviously.
But obviously it was not.
These idiots actually believe it. Like, these things inspire great hatred within me. It's purposeful ignorance.
Well, pretty much. I mean, that's how a lot of these things go. You try to rewrite history, and then, you know, you strike.
Like Poland.
Well, obviously Poland tried to, you know, rewrite history.
Well, Poland is very special.
Mm.
And actually, Poland had a strike of teachers today.
Oh.
Because they are kind of trying to change the history. And then the teachers are like, no. And then they were like, we are going to give you more money. And the teachers are like, still no. We just want history as it actually happened.
So what part of history are they trying to rewrite, so to speak?
It's mostly about the Second World War. They are trying to say, at the same time, mind you, that Poland is a very special victim snowflake, but at the same time, Poland is a very special resistance snowflake.
So in other words, we're like, we totally won the war, guys, but we also are a victim.
Yeah, exactly. They totally killed all the Nazis, but they totally got
butchered by Nazis.
Most victimized by the Nazis and deserved the most money.
In the end, it's all about reparations. I demand reparations too. Back, where's my Ruhr area? I'm still expecting it, you know.
No.
Oh.
No, not getting it. You're not giving it to the Dutch.
That means war.
But okay. I'll throw you a bone here. So instead of me, can my brother have it?
No.
Oh.
Maybe if you lower the dikes really fast, the sea is going to rush in so quickly that it'll flood Germany too.
Yeah, that's a good idea. So Beck, if you don't do it, I'll walk down to the dikes and I'm not talking about a lesbian bar here. I'm talking about an actual dike, and I'm going to kick it down. And it's gonna flood, and it's going to go all the way to the Ruhr area. Then it's gonna be all wet.
Then we will do our super. Then we will raise our super secret wall or dike to keep Dutch people out. So you will be like flooded with your land, and we'll be like, yes, the world is free of Dutch people.
But
this is a better world.
But the joke's on you, because we actually already prepared for the inevitable flooding. So we just become a floating city. And then we become the most powerful seafaring city. And
do you know, like Germany is trying to divert the flood. Activate the windmills.
And,
that's pretty badass.
And
we will send Don Quixote.
And also, we'll all automatically be the largest seaport in the world again. Because, you know, the entire country is a seaport now. You know, and I'll just stop being an animator, illustrator, and I'll just start a new harbor, Artrix Harbor, and I'll just ship goods and services. It's going to be very easy. I can do it straight from my window. So someone, you know, comes up to me with a boat. It's like, hey, can I ship something? I'm like, sure, here you go. And then I take my boat to go grocery shopping.
Yeah.
It's going to become
a very new city, Artrix Dam.
Yes, it's going to be just like that the video game, except instead of the sky, it's going to be in the water, and not under the water, but in it. So you know, it's not going to be like that one time when you're underwater and then some glass cracks and then you're fucked because everything's flooded.
It's going to be like Waterworld, but Dutch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's going to be like Waterworld, except everyone's not going to be a poor fag. So there was the only problem with those people. They were all poor. I mean, they were trading with sand for crying out loud. I mean, if they just had some money, you know. And anyway, so to wrap this up.
Well, we still didn't finish CN's new lineup.
Yes.
Yes, I'm going to be brief. So, stuff that got picked up for 2017-2018. Apple and Onion, regular show with Produce as main characters.
Oh,
then
nice.
Craig of the Creek, which I already mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
Summer Camp Island, which I already talked about in the past. It looks freaking weird.
I think I seen a clip. Wasn't that with the guy that ate the fruit and it was all about the fruit? And
No. Oh. Summer Camp Island is about those two animal kids that go to a magical summer camp.
Ah, I don't think I've seen that one before.
It looks like the art style looked very weird. I showed it to you.
Okay, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it left such a low impression on me that I don't fucking remember
it. Once it is over, I will show screenshots from all of these. All
right.
And OKKO, Let's Be Heroes, also already talked about. And now the two shows that were present in the Russian lineup, but not in the international lineup, The Heroic Quest of the Valiant Prince Ivandoe, which is a fantasy series made by the same people who made The Amazing World of Gumball.
Oh my god, no.
And the stuff that surprised me the most, that it is not on the international lineup, based on Unikitty from Lego Movie.
Wait, they're going to make an entire series around Lego Kitty?
Yeah.
That sounds like something that could work.
Obvious from the stuff they showed, it obviously seems like something made in America, yet it was not on the international lineup and only appeared on the Russian lineup.
Or maybe these shows aren't progressive enough, so you know they gotta show it in Russia because they're conservative
as well. Perhaps the shows will premiere in Europe and then will be shown in America later, like 2019. Because I know that the Ben 10 reboot originally premiered in Europe long before it premiered in the USA.
Why do people still care about Ben 10? I don't get it. I do get it. It's because of toys. It's toys.
I will show you all of the screenshots in the chat. All
right.
That's it for now. Please promise.
Speaking of cartoons and being good.
Oh, and also, I forgot. Also, two new animated shows for Adult Swim were greenlit.
Ooh, that does sound relevant to my interests.
The first one is called Hot Street, which is basically best described as the X-Files meets Inspector Gadget. two FBI agents that investigate paranormal occurrences, and one of the agent's niece and her dog are secretly helping them. This is the first one.
That's pretty much Inspector Gadget right there.
Co-created by Justin Roiland.
Ooh.
And the second one is called Apollo Gauntlet, which is about a cop, a fantasy world a la Conan the Barbarian, and gets a magical talking gauntlet and now fights evil and tries to get back to Earth.
Sounds pretty good.
Yeah, it actually, from the pilot I saw, it was surprisingly well written.
Well,
the main character.
Speaking, okay.
You can continue.
Well, basically, I was gonna say that so far, Samurai Jack is shaping up pretty good. I'm really enjoying the new season so far, and it's only been like two episodes.
Three, as of this point, three.
Three? Oh wait, they already. Oh yeah, it's been three episodes. I almost forgot about one, but it's
Samurai, the Maiden Murderer Jack.
Well, they were being shit. I mean, if you know, you're being chased by a bunch of women who have been raised from their very inception to kill you, and their entire life purpose is to kill you, and you're like, well, you're not going to convince them otherwise, so you might as well then.
Might as well earn that nickname.
That was the entire point of that. Your choices led you to this point, scene.
Mm-hmm. Well, they were like, he was like, well, you can still choose. You can be a shit, or you can be, you know, be a bit more reasonable and maybe think for yourself. And they were like, fuck no, I'm going to kill you.
And they were like, but Aku.
Aku is such a nice guy. I mean, he's only enslaving all of existence, but he's such a nice guy. Also, he's my dad, but he's such a nice guy. Just giving a chance, except not really, because I'm out here to kill you, because who's my father? Yeah, they have my condolences. I can kind of see why they're so pissed off, you know, Ku being their father and all. Speaking of which, the new voice actor they got for Aku does a pretty good job at portraying Aku. Not too familiar with the original voice, but I like the voice in this version. He's nice and crazy, which is kind of interesting about Aku as a character, because in the series does have a fairly serious tone, and then you have a character like Aku who's just silly. But he's also, you know, the most evil person in the entire universe in that series.
Woo!
He's almost a lovable character, but then you realize that he's responsible for the death of millions of people, and then he's not so lovable anymore.
Unless
you hate people.
Say that Adolf Hitler was a pretty pleasant person to hang around.
I wouldn't be surprised. I've seen some footage and it's like, oh, look at that, he's petting his doggy. Isn't that adorable?
Because the doggy was not a Jew.
Exactly. Now, if it was a Jew doggy, then things would have been different. He's like, hey, it's probably a good thing I don't remember the dog's name. So it's like, hey, doggy. Hey, what's
You're
that?
My favorite customer.
Yeah. The dog is like, woof woof. Then it's like, oh my god, did you just say that? The dog is like, woof woof. I never thought of it that way. And then he released all the Jews. And that's the story about...
Adolf, what you baking? Oh, never mind. The joke... The point of the joke is Jews.
Mm-hmm. And ovens.
And Holocaust.
Yes.
Come on, there's nothing funny about the Holocaust.
A holy cast.
Holy cast.
The next time I break my hand, I'm going to get my cast blessed. So I have a holy cast to...
Yeah.
I agree. You should end it.
I should probably end this episode. So yeah, I guess this episode is slightly shorter than usual, which is actually kind of a good thing because the last few episodes have tended to be kind of long. So consider this a nice little short episode of Radio Rothingham in before I keep talking for the next 20 minutes. So just to make the episode as long as the usual episode. Except I won't! So like, subscribe, do all that good jazz. And see you guys next week for yet another retarded episode of the least professional podcast on the entire internet, also known as Radio Rothingham.
Good night.
Cheers.